Joanna's World, Classic WoW Speed Leveling. New Guide Features. Reworked for all classes, I have spent a lot of time reworking my guide so it is more usable for all classes by listing quests that can be skipped for tough elites that cannot be soloed by certain classes and telling them they can solo that elite later in the guide once they are higher level. And a lot of sections have been reworked so harder quests are done later on without losing time. Duo leveling friendly. Over the last 1.5 years I have put in a lot of effort to make my leveling guides duo leveling friendly, including quests that requires 2 or even 3 players. I have recently been getting good reports from duo levelers saying my leveling guides worked great for them in this regard. Individual class steps. So far we have all the Horde and Alliance starting zones complete with all class steps. You will see a class menu at the top of the screen for those guides. The page will dynamically update all the steps and images in the guide to your specific class. 1260 Horde Hunter, Warlock, Warrior and Druid are finished along with 1260 Alliance Hunter as well. The rest will come slowly over time. Inventory management. My new guides now tell players to bank many items throughout the guide, mostly quest items, to help you free up bag space. I tell players when to put an item in the bank and when to take them out. Bag space is very valuable in Classic WoW. Having quest items remain in your inventory for long periods of time is damaging. Some quest items never disappear and some are not even used at all and can be destroyed. This new feature will help you gain more gold and be more efficient. Improved routes. I am constantly going through these guides again and again. Each time I am constantly trying to find faster methods for everything. Some big route changes include moving the entire Silithus section from level 55 to level 58. This allowed me to include a lot more quests for that zone, making the final 59 grind much shorter. And quests like Death Clasp is much easier to do at that level. Level 29 Hillsprad Foothills on the Horde side has been revamped and now includes a lot more quests for that zone. Many small improvements everywhere and I include many new hidden shortcuts in the game world to reduce travel time. Argent Dawn turn-ins. The guides now include all the quick and easy turn-ins for Light's Hope Chapel in EPL from the Argent Dawn. This is a good chunk of easy and quick XP that my previous guides never mentioned. In-game guide versions are coming. My in-game guide version of my leveling guides are still being worked on and should start to be available soon. I suspect that starting zones will be finished first followed by the rest of the content. It will probably take a number of months before they are finished and I don't expect to have any in-game guides ready for Classic launch. But the web guides are in really good shape. What is this site about? Vanilla 160 WoW was a huge speedrun project I worked on full-time from 2004 to 2007 during the times of 160 Vanilla WoW. I have produced a very useful 160 Vanilla WoW Horde leveling guide and a 160 Vanilla WoW speedrun video. You can find a lot more info, including screenshots of my 160 speed leveling journeys here. Also, feel free to follow me on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, and Twitch. My real gamer name is Furious Paul, while Joanna is the name of my WoW character. I will continue to use Joanna for all my WoW endeavors. Read more Joanna's World, Classic WoW Speed Leveling, please click link in description below.